Hi, my name is Ron Burkhart. I've been at Salem Baptist Church for about 10 years now. When I was 3 years old, my parents became Christians. They trusted Christ as their Savior. And my father had never had an earthly father. And I believe that when he realized he had a heavenly father who had died for him, that made such a difference to his life that he wanted to tell everyone that he came in contact, which he literally did. I'm making the gospel known to them, and I basically heard that many, many times in my life. As a young person growing up, I heard it and I heard it, and as I went into my middle ages, my early teen years, there's a scripture in John 10:27 which says, and it's Jesus talking, "My sheep hear my voice, and I know them, and they follow me, and I'll give them eternal life." And basically at that point in my life, I knew he was a shepherd, but I had nothing to do with him, and I didn't do any of the things that he would want me to do because he wasn't my shepherd. And so as I got later in my teen years, I started picking up some habits. I started smoking pot, drank beer or alcohol or whatever that was available. And then I went to college, went to a Christian college where all those things were against the rules. However, you go to a place like that, and just like in church, we have people come to church every day, every week, who are dead in their sin, and they don't know Christ because they've never had that relationship with him. And that's basically what I did when I went to college. Met friends just like me, continued the lifestyle. And by the end of my junior year, I decided to drop out of college because I was basically living a pointless life. I really wasn't there for education, I was there to party. And I thought, well, I better get on with my life. You can't live that lifestyle without any money. Well, I got married. I was involved. I was in charge of our Awana clubs. I taught Sunday school, very active in church, high 6 days a week, but nobody in church knew that. My wife didn't know that. My parents didn't know that, but I think they all suspected me. But since I was very active, nobody ever questioned me. At the time there was a group, and I loved rock music. Music has always been a huge part of my life. And I thank God when he saved me, he changed my music appetite as well. But there was a group that had a song entitled "I'm on the Highway to Hell," and many times at night that song would pound through my mind as I was laying in bed, because I knew I'd heard the gospel many times from my father growing up in church. I'd heard the gospel hundreds and thousands of times, but it didn't mean anything to me because God hadn't opened my eyes to see the truth. And I never come to that point in my life where it's like, this is the appointed day where God's gonna save me. But that song would literally keep me awake at night. I was afraid to go to sleep because I believed enough of the Bible that I knew if I died, I would go to hell. But yet I was still stubborn. I didn't want to do that because I thoroughly enjoyed my lifestyle. I have to be honest and say I really did. It was more like a religion to me because it brought such pleasure to my life, but such selfish pleasure. Well, on September 3rd, 1984, a pastor was reading a text, Matthew 23, and Jesus himself is talking to the Pharisees. And he's basically calling them hypocrites. He calls them hypocrites several different ways. And in verse 28, it says, "Hypocrites, you who appear to be so righteous, yet are so full of iniquity." And it was just at that point in time, it was like a hand pointed out of the Bible and pointed right at me. And that had been a weekend where God had really been working in my heart to see that, you know, the joy and the peace that I was striving for in alcohol and in drugs was a pointless. I mean, there was no end. It's like tomorrow I have to come back and I have to try this again and I have to try this again, and the peace is just short, very short lived. And that was all I heard the pastor say that day. And I believe in my seat that day God opened my eyes up and I realized I was a sinner and he had died for me and the gospel made sense to me. And I believe I trusted him right in my seat. But when the invitation was given, I came forward to talk to the pastor, who didn't believe me, because I was in charge of Awana clubs and I taught Sunday school and I did a lot of good things in the church. But as I said in that text, Jesus was addressing the religious people, and that's who I was a religious dead person. He talks about them having dead bones. And from that day forth, my life has changed. The next day on my way to work, my normal ritual was to get high. And that day it was like there was no appetite, no desire for that. And it was like in my life, it was such a lifestyle that I had. It was like, I will do this till I die. But it was like God had changed my life. The Bible in 2 Corinthians 5:17 says, "If any man's in Christ, he's a new creation. Old things have passed away and everything has become new." And I watched in my life as God started changing my habits, my desires, my want-tos. Many people go to church week in and week out. There are many people go to all different types of churches and they're trying to just go through a formality. There's a lot of people that probably come to our church on a weekly basis who are full of dead man's bones. And if they were standing before God right now, he'd say, I don't know you. And we only have one opportunity, we only have one life to trust God. And today is the best day. If I didn't know him, I would say today's the best day. I said many times to many people, if I'd have known the joy and the pleasure that Jesus Christ can give, that he fills you up with, I'd have said, why did I waste all this time? Why did I spend all this money chasing the pleasures of the world, which leave you empty?